Coming up after the break, the cancer that killed actor Chadwick Boseman is one of the most common forms of the disease. Next, what you should know about detecting colon cancer before it kills. You're streaming CBSN. Fans are reeling from the shocking news of actor Chadwick Boseman's sudden passing on Friday from colon cancer. The actor was famous for iconic roles like Jackie Robinson, Thurgood Marshall, and T'Challa, the King of Wakanda. The tweet that described his legacy and announced his passing became the most liked post in Twitter history. Twitter made note of the record, writing, "Most liked tweet ever, a tribute fit for a king." Along with Black Panther, Boseman portrayed some of the most important people in civil rights history. Our Michael George looks back at a decade of stardom cut short and the inspiring legacy that he left behind.
Chadwick Boseman brought black heroes to life on the big screen. A young Thurgood Marshall, James Brown in Get On Up, Jackie Robinson in 42.
Give me a number on my back, I'll give you the guts.
Marvel superhero who broke barriers.
Wakanda forever!
Boseman's death stunned Hollywood and fans everywhere. His family says the cause was colon cancer, diagnosed 4 years ago, a private battle endured while performing in some of his biggest roles. If 42 was his breakout role, the 2018 blockbuster Black Panther changed everything. For so many black boys and girls, it was the first time they saw a superhero on screen who looked like them.
It's taking on its own meaning right now. I'm seeing that it's a cultural experience.
Today, actress Viola Davis tweeted, "No words to express my devastation of losing you." Boseman also spoke out against racial injustice, defending Colin Kaepernick for taking a knee.
We're in a period of time where people have to decide what is patriotism.
His last tweet, a message of support for vice presidential nominee Kamala Harris. Former President Obama says to be young, gifted, and black, to use that power to give them heroes to look up to do it all while in pain. What a use of his years. Boseman died at home in Los Angeles, his family at his side. Michael George, CBS News.
Boseman's colon cancer was diagnosed 4 years ago but kept private, and his unexpected passing has brought renewed public attention to the third most common type of cancer in the United States. To talk about the disease that cut short the actor's life, I want to bring in Dr. David Spigel. He's an oncologist and chief scientific officer at the Sarah Cannon Cancer Research Institute, and he joins us now from Nashville, Tennessee. Doctor, it's good to have you with us. He was just 39 when he was diagnosed. How common is colon cancer in someone that young?
Well, it's uncommon. I mean, most young people don't get cancer. Colon cancer can occur at any age, but it typically occurs after the age of 50, and actually most patients are over the age of 65. But there can be patients who are diagnosed below the age of 50. In fact, this is probably the most concerning trend over the last several years, is an increase in the identification of patients under the age of 50.
I wonder if because of that, there might be a change in the recommendations. The American Cancer Society is recommending that the average person begin regular screenings at age 45. As we discussed, Boseman was diagnosed with an advanced case in his late 30s. Overall, are we screening enough? Are we screening at a young enough age? Can everyone who needs a test or wants a test get one?
Well, it's a great question. We've been under the impression that cancer occurs later, so screening can occur later. And 50, as you point out, used to be the cutoff. In fact, it's still the cutoff for colonoscopy recommendations for both men and women. But as you point out, in 2018, the American Cancer Society changed the recommendations and increased or lowered the age cutoff to 45. Some have even wondered whether African Americans should have a lower cutoff of 45 also. But still some controversy about the right age, and certainly below the age of 45 is not a standard recommendation unless there's some personal family history, strong history otherwise.
I'm glad you brought up that last point about African Americans and perhaps changing their date of screening, because they have higher mortality rates from colon cancer, even after adjusting for comorbidities. What accounts for this, and is the age of screening different? Does it tend to be younger for African American males than their white counterparts?
Well, we know that young African American males will have a higher risk of colon cancer. So if you look, let me say that another way. If you look at young people who have colon cancer, an African American individual is more likely to have that. We know that colonoscopy can find it. We don't know what causes it, though. We think about things like dietary, lifestyle changes, family history, as I mentioned. But at the end of the day, we don't know why it would be that younger individuals would be at a higher risk of colon cancer. Moreover, we don't know why African Americans would be at a higher risk than Caucasians. It's just not clear. There's a lot of folks looking at this issue. In particular, kind of an emerging topic is something called the microbiome, kind of this this innate colonization of bacteria in the bowel, and maybe changes in that over the last 10 or 20 years has something to do with the changes in incident rates. But the bottom line is we don't know. We don't have a good explanation. And so screening is really our only tool to try to find cancer early to do something about it.
Well, in the case of Mr. Bozeman, his cancer was at stage 3 when it was discovered. Could you briefly tell us about the different stages of colon cancer and the warning signs?
Yeah, sure. So for like any cancer, we try to know where it is, and it starts with something called staging. And so most individuals are probably familiar with the term called stage 4, which means advanced or metastatic disease. And that implies cancer that has already spread to some other location from where it started. Stage 3 cancer, in the case of Mr. Bozeman, implies a cancer that was in what are called the lymph nodes or glands outside of the colon. And then the stages go down from there in terms of less spread through the bowel wall and then a smaller lesion. We know that for younger individuals who often don't think that they might have cancer, and certainly their physicians managing them don't necessarily expect that, that when they do get diagnosed, it can be at a later stage. And so stage 3, certainly a curable stage, is still a higher risk stage. And of course, stage 4 cancer is when cancer has spread and in general is not going to be a curable condition. But all stages of cancer, of course, are treatable. And we don't have a lot of details about Mr. Bozeman's care, what has happened over the last 4 years. But not really an unusual story to be diagnosed with cancer and to fight it. What's a bit unusual, I've learned, is how quiet he kept this story and really how heroic he was at fighting through that without really a lot of people around him knowing about it.
Truly heroic, the movies that he was filming while all of this was going on, his strength and power while he was battling so hard against this colon cancer. Obviously, colon cancer occurs more often in men, and we're talking about a man in this case, but it's obviously worth a reminder also that 25,000 women die from it annually. I truly don't know. Are there any differences between men and women in terms of how it presents, some of the symptoms that people ought to be looking out for?
Yeah, you asked me about that earlier, and I apologize. I didn't get to that. So what are the symptoms? Well, it depends on the stage, right? So if somebody had advanced cancer or were to spread to, say, another organ, the symptoms that present to a person, their family, or their physician might be related to where that cancer spread to, say, another organ. For early stage cancer, stage 1, 2, or 3, sometimes it can be subtle. It might be changes in the bowel habits. It might be blood in the stool. It might be bright blood, or it might be black, kind of black tarry coloring to the stool, which can be a surprise, of course, a big change to individuals. For more advanced disease, it might be a change in weight or a change in appetite. But I guess the bottom line is it can be subtle, and for that reason, we have to screen. We have to go looking for cancer. In terms of gender issues, so it's important to note for both men and women, it is the third most common cancer that we see. There'll be about 150,000 individuals who will be diagnosed with colon cancer in an average year. About 40 to 50,000 individuals will die from colon cancer. So you can see most fortunately get diagnosed hopefully early enough that they can be cured from it. But there still are a large number of individuals who will die from colon cancer. I don't think we know that there's a true difference in gender that's been discussed, and there's some, there might be some reasons in terms of biology for that, but like with African Americans and Caucasians, we really don't understand that well. And it's important to say this, that for both men and women, there is no difference in how you should be screened. Both men and women should undergo colonoscopy. That is the best tool we can use to find it. Whether that's at age 45 or 50, I think depends on some of these guidelines. I personally think 45 is probably a more appropriate guideline for both men and women across the board.
All right, Dr. David Spigel, thank you for joining us, Chief Medical Officer at the Sarah Cannon Cancer Research Institute.
Thank you.